This is how we worship. Prepare worship with prayer. Wear proper attire. Bring your Bible. Prepare your offering. Sit properly for worship. Organize and clean your surroundings. Avoid distractions. Lift up your voice for praise and worship. And finally, give God your full attention. Let's worship!
Good morning, guys! This is Eunji. Yay! How are you doing? How was your week? Did you miss me? I miss you. Yeah. I saw your passionate worship last week. I was so happy for you. You guys did really good job. Our Jesus received our worship joyfully. You know, again, we also can give great job to our Jesus. How? Yes, we can praise God eagerly and passionately. So let's jump into the worship. Are you guys ready? Let's go! Go!
More. Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. When I read the Bible, it tells me how to live. When I read the Bible, it tells me He forgives. 'Cause yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. When I read the Bible, it shows me how to love. And when I read the Bible, it makes me think of how, yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. The Bible tells me so.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. My hope is built Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. Christ alone.
예수님의 이름으로 기도합니다. 아멘. Chapter 3. The boy Samuel ministered before the Lord under Eli. In those days, the word of the Lord was rare. There were not many visions. One night, Eli, whose eyes were becoming so weak that he could barely see, was lying down in his usual place. The lamp of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. Then the Lord called Samuel. Samuel answered,
"Here I am."
And he ran to Eli and said,
"Here I am. You called me."
But Eli said,
"I did not call. Go back and lie down."
So he went and lay down. Again the Lord called,
"Samuel."
And Samuel got up and went to Eli and said,
"Here I am. You called me."
"My son,"
Eli said,
"I did not call. Go back and lie down."
Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord. The word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel a third time. And Samuel got up and went to Eli and said,
"Here I am. You called me."
Then Eli realized that the Lord was calling the boy. So Eli told Samuel,
"Go and lie down. And if he calls you, say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'"
So Samuel went and lay down in his place. The Lord came and stood there, calling as at the other times,
"Samuel, Samuel."
Then Samuel said,
"Speak, for your servant is listening."
And the Lord said to Samuel,
"See, I am about to do something in Israel that will make the ears of everyone who hears of it tingle. At that time, I will carry out against Eli everything I spoke against his family from beginning to end. For I told him that I would judge his family forever because of the sin he knew about. His sons made themselves contemptible, and he failed to restrain them. Therefore, I swore to the house of Eli, the guilt of Eli's house will never be atoned for by sacrifice or offering."
Samuel lay down until morning, and then opened the doors of the house of the Lord. He was afraid to tell Eli the vision, but Eli called him and said,
"Samuel, my son."
Samuel answered,
"Here I am."
"What was it he said to you?"
Eli asked.
"Do not hide it from me. May God deal with you, be it ever so severely, if you hide from me anything he told you."
So Samuel told him everything, hiding nothing from him. Then Eli said,
"He is the Lord. Let him do what is good in his eyes."
The Lord was with Samuel as he grew up, and he let none of his words fall to the ground. And all Israel, from Dan to Beersheba, recognized that Samuel was attested as a prophet of the Lord. The Lord continued to appear at Shiloh, and there he revealed himself to Samuel through his word.
Hello everybody, good to see you guys again. Today's word is about the story of Samuel. God called Samuel. Welcome to Pastor Jin's Story Bible. Yay! If someone calls us, we usually answer, right? By the way, when we answer, we should answer well, because if you answer to the calling rudely, the listener may feel really bad. For example, your mom called you. "Hey, honey. Hey, Gospel. Hey, Eugene." Then how we usually answer? What if we answer so rudely? "What?
What?"
Or what if we answer like, "Why, mom?
What?"
Then our mom will feel so bad, right? But what if we answer so kindly and nice? "Yes, mom, I'm here." And good conversation will start from the moment. It is same to God. So, when God calls us, "Leon," or "June," "Ahim," we also should answer well to God. And then God will give us many blessings, right? Amen, amen. In today's word, there was a boy, Samuel. And Samuel is the son of Hannah. Samuel was a really good boy. and he listened to parents well, very well at home. When Hannah had pregnant Samuel, she promised God to offer Samuel as a servant of God. I pray for this child, and the Lord has granted me what I asked of him. So now I give him to the Lord. For his whole life, he will be given over to the Lord, and he worshiped the Lord there. So, when Samuel became a boy, she sent Samuel to the high priest Eli and let him take the lesson being the high priest. So Samuel was educated by high priest Eli, such as like Bible and how to worship and the law of God. He was every day, little by little, growing and growing very well in the grace of God. So Samuel was growing up well, very well, right? One day, after Samuel finished every study and he was going back to his bed. He went back to his bed and he went to sleep. When Samuel was sleeping, Samuel suddenly listened to a calling. A voice.
Samuel! Samuel!
Oh my gosh! Samuel was so surprised. Who called me? He ran to the high priest Eli and asked, Master, did you call me?
No, I didn't.
So Samuel thought he misheard. So he went back to the bed and fell asleep again. By the way, he listened to the voice again.
Samuel! Samuel!
So Samuel was so surprised. What did I hear? So Samuel ran again to Eli and asked him again. Master, did you call me?
No, I didn't.
So Samuel went back to his bed again, and now he fell really into the deep sleep. By the way, he listened to the voice again really loudly.
Samuel! Samuel!
What? Samuel was surprised again when Samuel ran again to Eli and asked again. Master, did you call me? And Eli answered,
No, I didn't.
At the moment, Eli recognized that God was calling Samuel. So he gave an advice to Samuel. Samuel, go and lie down. And if God calls you again, say, Big Lord, for your servant listening. As Eli said, Samuel focused on God's voicing. And so he was sleeping. And God called Samuel again.
Samuel.
So Samuel was surprised. Now Samuel wake up, and Samuel answered as Eli taught him. Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. So now Samuel was focusing on God's voice, and God started telling him one by one. So Samuel focus on God's voice. He was growing up, yeah. Now he's listening. God started to speak to Samuel, and from that moment, God used Samuel as prophet. prophet are saving Israel from crisis. Dear KCPC children, again, God told us many things. We must listen to His voice. You know, sometimes God tells us through the Bible, through our heart, and through our parents. And what should we do? Yes, as Samuel did, we should focus on God's voice and answer, Lord, here I am, speak to me, and that God will bless you guys and work with you many things. This week, let's read the Bible, pray well, and listen to God's voice and His order. Let's obey His commandments to us. Like this, let's be the good children of God who makes God pleased. Amen? Yep. God bless KCPC. Yeah. I will see you guys next week again. This week, let's listen to our God's voice well. God bless KCPC. I love you. Bye.
John 4:14. The Father has sent His Son.
Thank you. The monkeys in the jungle say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
The monkeys in the jungle say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
The monkeys in the jungle say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Thank you, Lord, for making me. Oh, let everything that God made say thank you, Lord. Let everything that God made say thank you, Lord. Let everything that God made say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for making me.
The bears and the